Nematodes. Introduction. The nematodes or roundworms constitute the phylum Nematoda. They are diverse animal phylum inhabiting a very broad range of environments. Nematode species can be difficult to distinguish, and although over 25,000 have been described, of which more than half are parasitic, the total number of nematode species has been estimated to be about 1 million. Unlike the cnidarians and flatworms, nematodes have tubular digestive systems with openings at both ends. They belong to the kingdom Animalia, the clade Nemateoda, and the phylum Nematoda. Habitats. Nematodes have successfully adapted to nearly every ecosystem, from marine to freshwater to soils, and from the polar regions to the tropics, as well as the highest to the lowest of elevations. They are ubiquitous in freshwater, marine, and terrestrial environments, where they often outnumber other animals in both individual and species counts. They are found in locations as diverse as mountains, deserts, and oceanic trenches. They are also found in every part of the Earth's lithosphere. They represent, for example, 90% of all life forms on the ocean floor. Their numerical dominance, often exceeding a million individuals per square meter and accounting for about 80% of all individual animals on the earth. Their diversity of life cycles and their presence at various trophic levels point at an important role in many ecosystems. There are many parasitic forms, include pathogens in most plants and animals, including humans. Some nematodes can undergo cryptobiosis. One group of carnivorous fungi, the nematophagous fungi, are predators of soil nematodes. They set entisements for the nematodes in the form of lossos or adhesive structures. Nematodes have ever been found at great depth, 0.9 to 3.6 kilometers below the surface of the earth in gold mines in South Africa. Let us now see the taxonomy and the systematics. At its origin, the Nematodia included both roundworms and horsehair worms. Along with Acanthocephala, Trematoda, and Cestodia, it formed the group Entozoa. The first differentiation of roundworms from horsehair worms, though erroneous, is due to von Siebold, 1843, with orders Nematodia and Gordiacea. They were classed along with Acanthocephala in the new phylum Nemanthelmines. The taxon Nematodia, including the family Gordiidae, that is the horsehair worms, was then promoted to the rank of the phylum by Ray Lankester. In 1919, Nathan Cobb proposed the roundworms should be recognized alone as a phylum. He argued they should be called the Nema or the Nemas in English rather than nematodes, and defined the taxon Nemates. Since Cobb was the first to exclude all but nematodes from the group, some sources consider the valid taxon name to be Nemates or Nemata rather than Nematoda. Phylogeny. The relationships of the nematodes and their close relatives among the protostomian metazoa are unresolved. Traditionally, they were held to be a lineage of their own, but in the 1990s, they were proposed to form the group Ecdysozoa together with molting animals such as arthropods. The identity of the closest living relatives of the nematoda has always been considered to be well resolved. Morphological characters and molecular phylogenesis agree with placement of the roundworms as a sister taxon to the parasitic horsehair worms. Together, they make up the nematoida. Together with the scalidophora, the nematodia forms the introverta. It is entirely unclear whether the introverta are in turn the closest living relatives of the enigmatic gastrotrichia. If so, they are considered a clade cycloneuralia. But much disagreement occurs both between and among the available morphological and molecular data. The understanding of roundworm systematics and phylogeny as of 2002 is summarized below. Phylum Nematoda. Number 1. Basal order Monhysterida. Class Dorylamia. Class Enoplia. Class Secrinetia. Chromadoria assemblage. Later work has suggested the presence of 12 clades. The Secrinetia, a group that includes virtually all major animals and plant nematode parasites, apparently arose from within the Adenophora. A major effort to improve the systematics of this phylum is in progress and being organized by the 959 nematode genomes. A complete checklist of the world's nematode species can be found in the World Species Index, Nematoda. An analysis of the mitochondrial DNA suggests the following groupings are valid. Subclass Dorylamia, orders Rhabditia, Trichinellidia and Marmitida. Suborder Raptidina, infraorder Spirulomorpha and Oxyurodormorpha. The Ascaridomorpha and the Rhabdiomorpha and the Diplogastyromorpha appear to be related. The suborders Spirurina and the Tylikina and the infraorders Rhabdomorphia and Tylinkomorpha are paraphytic. Anatomy. Nematodes are slender worms, typically approximately 5 to 100 micrometers thick and at least 0.1 millimeters but less than 2.5 millimeters long. The smallest nematodes are microscopic, while free living species can reach as much as 5 centimeters, and some parasitic species are larger, still reaching over a meter in length. The body is often ornamented with ridges, rings, bristles and other distinctive structures. The head of the nematode is relatively distinct, whereas the rest of the body is bilaterally symmetrical. The head is radially symmetrical with the sensory bristles and in many cases solid head shields radiating outward around the mouth. The mouth has either 3 or 6 lips, which often bear a series of teeth on their inner edges. An adhesive, the caudal gland, is often found at the tip of the tail. The epidermis is either a synthium or a single layer of cells and is covered by a thick collagenous cuticle. The cuticle is often of complex structure and may have 2 or 3 distinct layers. Underneath the epidermis lies a layer of longitudinal muscle cells. The relatively rigid cuticle works with the muscles to create a hydroskeleton, as nematodes lack circumferential muscles. Projections run from the inner surface of the muscle cells towards the nerve cords. This is a unique arrangement in the animal kingdom, in which nerve cells normally extend fibers into the muscles rather than vice versa. Let us now study the digestive system. The oral cavity is lined with cuticle, which is often strengthened with ridges or other structures, and especially in carnivorous species may bear a number of teeth. The mouth often includes a sharp stylet which the animal can thrust into its prey. In some species, the stylet is hollow and can be used to suck liquids from plants or animals. The oral cavity opens into a muscular sucking pharynx also lined with cuticle. Digestive glands are found in this region of the gut, producing enzymes that start to break down the food. The stylet-bearing species, these may even be injected into the prey. There is no stomach with the pharynx connecting directly to a muscle's intestine that forms the main length of the gut. This produces further enzymes and also absorbs nutrients through its single cell thick lining. The last portion of the intestine is lined by cuticle, forming a rectum which expels waste through the anus, just below and in front of the tip of the tail. Movement of food through the digestive system is the result of body movements of the worm. The intestine has valves or sphincters at either end to help control the movement of food through the body. Let us now look at the excretory system. Nitrogenous waste is excreted in the form of ammonia through the body wall and is not associated with any specific organs. However, the structures for excreting salt to maintain osmoregulation are typically more complex. In many marine nematodes, one or two unicellular rhenate glands excrete salt through a pore on the underside of the animal close to the pharynx. In most other nematodes, these specialized cells have been replaced by an organ consisting of two parallel ducts connected by a single transverse duct. This transverse duct opens into a common canal that runs to the excretory pore. Let us now look at the nervous system. Four peripheral nerves run the length of the body on the dorsal, ventral, and lateral surfaces. Each nerve lies within a cord of connective tissue lying beneath the cuticle and between the muscle cells. The ventral nerve is the largest and has a double structure forward of the excretory pore. The dorsal nerve is responsible for motor control, while the lateral nerves are sensory and the ventral combines both the functions. At the anterior end of the animal, the nerves branch from a dense circular nerve ring surrounding the pharynx and serving as the brain. Smaller nerves run forward from the ring to supply the sensory organs of the head. The bodies of nematodes are covered in numerous sensory bristles and papillae that together provide a sense of touch. Behind the sensory bristles on the head lie two small pits or the amphids. These are well supplied with nerve cells and are probably chemoreception glands. A few aquatic nematodes possess what appear to be pigmented eye spots, but is unclear whether or not these are actually sensory in nature. Let us now look at the reproduction system. Most nematode species are dioecious, with separate male and female individuals. Both sexes possess one or two tubular gonads. In males, the sperm are produced at the end of the gonad and migrate along its length as they mature. The testis each open into a relatively wide sperm duct and then into a glandular and muscular ejaculatory duct associated with the cloaca. In females, the ovaries each open into an oviduct and then a glandular uterus. The uteri both open into a common vagina, usually located at the middle of the ventral surface. Reproduction is usually sexual. Males are usually smaller than females and often have a characteristic bent tail for holding the female. During copulation, one or more chitinized spicules move out of the cloaca and are inserted into the genital pore of the female. Amoeboid sperm crawl along the spicule into the female worm. Nematode sperm is thought to be the only eukaryotic cell without the globular protein G-actin. Eggs may be embryonated or unembryonated when passed by the female, meaning their fertilized eggs may not yet be developed. A few species are known to be oviviparous. The eggs are protected by an outer shell secreted by the uterus. In free-living roundworms, the eggs hatch into larvae, which appear essentially identical to the adults, except for an underdeveloped reproductive system. In parasitic roundworms, the life cycle is often much more complicated. Nematodes as a whole possess a wide range of modes of reproduction. Some nematodes, such as the Heterorhabditis species, undergo a process called endotocheia matricida, that is, intrauterine birth causing maternal death. Some nematodes are hermaphroditic and keep their self-fertilized eggs inside the uterus until they hatch. The juvenile nematodes will then ingest the parent nematode. This process is significantly promoted in environments with low food supply. The nematode model species C. eleganus and C. brixae exhibit androdoiky, which is very rare among animals. The single genus, that is the root knot nematodes, exhibit a range of reproductive modes including sexual reproduction, facultative sexuality, in which most but not all generations reproduce asexually, and both meiotic and mitotic parthenogenesis. The genus Mesorhabditis exhibits an unusual form of parthenogenesis in which sperm-producing males copulate with females, but the sperm do not fuse with the ovum. Contact with the sperm is essential for the ovum to begin dividing. But because there is no fusion of the cells, the male contributes no genetic material to the offspring, which are essential clones of the female. The free-living species. In the free-living species, development usually consists of four molds of the cuticle during growth. Different species feed on materials as varied as algae, fungi, small animals, fecal matter, dead organisms, and living tissues. Free-living marine nematodes are important and abundant numbers of the meiobenthos. They play an important role in the decomposition process, aid in recycling of nutrients in marine environments, and are sensitive to changes in the environment caused by pollution. Roundworms of the note Cynorhabditis elegans lives in the soil and has found much use as a model organism. C. elegans has had its entire genome sequenced, as well as the developmental fate of every cell determined and every neuron mapped. The parasitic species. Nematodes commonly are parasitic on humans, including ascarids, filarias, hookworms, pinworms, and whipworms. The species Trichelina spiralis, commonly known as the trichina worm, occurs in rats, pigs, and humans and is responsible for the disease trichiniosis. Balisarcasis usually infests wild animals but can be deadly to humans as well. Dirofilaria immitis are known for causing heartworm disease by inhabiting the hearts, the arteries, and lungs of dogs and some cats. Haemonychus contortus is one of the most abundant infectious agents in sheep around the world, causing great economic damage to sheep. In contrast, entomopathogenic nematodes parasitize insects and are considered by humans to be beneficial. One form of nematode is entirely dependent upon fig wasps, which are the sole source of fig fertilization. They prey upon the wasps, riding them from the ripe fig of the wasp's birth to the fig flower of its death, where they kill the wasp and the offspring await the birth of the next generation of wasps as the fig ripens. A newly discovered parasitic tetradonematid nematode, Marmaiconima neotropicum, apparently induces fruit mimicry in the tropical ant Cephalotus atratus. Infected ants develop bright red gasters, tend to be more sluggish and walk with their gasters in conspicuous elevated position. These changes likely cause frugivorous birds to confuse the infected ants for berries and eat them. Parasite eggs passed into the bird's feces are subsequently collected by foraging Cephalotus atratus and are fed into their larvae, thus completing the life cycle of M. neotropicum. Plant parasitic nematodes include several groups causing severe crop losses. The most common genera are the foliar nematodes, the potato cyst nematodes, the soybean cyst nematodes, the root knot nematodes, the lesion nematodes, the dagger nematodes. Several phytoparasitic nematode species cause histological damages to roots, including the formation of visible galls. Example, by root knot nematodes, which are useful characters for their diagnostic in the field. Some nematode species transmit plant viruses through their feeding activity on roots. One of them is Xiphenema index, vector of grapevine fan leaf virus, an important disease of grapes. Other nematodes attack bark in forest trees. The most important representative of this group is Bursa phalangis xylophilus, the pine wood nematode, present in Asia and America and are recently discovered in Europe. Agriculture and horticulture. Depending on the species, a nematode may be beneficial or detrimental to plant health. From agriculture and horticulture perspectives, the two categories of nematodes are the predatory ones, which will kill garden pests like cutworms and corn earworm moths, and the pest nematodes like the root knot nematode, which attack plants, and those that act as vectors spreading plant viruses between crop plants. Predatory nematodes can be bred by soaking a specific recipe of leaves and other detritus in water in a dark, cool place, and can even be purchased as an organic form of pest control. Rotations of plants with nematode-resistant species or varieties is one means of managing parasitic nematode infestations. For example, marigolds grown over one of the more seasons that can be used to control nematodes. Another is treatment with natural antagonists such as the fungus Gliocardium roseum. Chitosan, a natural biocontrol, elicits plant defense responses to destroy parasitic cyst nematodes on roots of soybean, corn, sugar beet, potato and tomato crops without harming beneficial nematodes in the soil. Furthermore, soil steaming is an efficient method to kill nematodes before planting the crop, but indiscriminately eliminates both harmful and beneficial ones. The golden nematode is a particularly harmful variety of nematode pest that has resulted in quarantines and crop failures worldwide. CSIRO has found a 13 to 14 fold reduction of nematode population densities in plots having Indian mustard, green manure or seed meal in the soil. Hundreds of nematodes were featured in a research project on NASA's STS-107 space mission and were the only known living organisms to have survived the Space Shuttle Columbia disaster. Epidemiology. A number of intestinal nematodes cause diseases affecting human beings, including ascariasis, trichuriasis and hookworm disease. Filarial nematodes cause filariasis. The soil ecosystems. 90% of nematodes reside in the top 15 centimeters of soil. Nematodes do not decompose organic matter, but instead are parasitic and free living organisms that feed on living material. soil ecosystems. 90% of nematodes reside in the top 15 centimeters of soil. Nematodes do not decompose organic matter, but instead are parasitic and free living organisms that feed on living material. Nematodes can effectively regulate bacterial population and community composition. They may eat up to 5,000 bacteria per minute. Also, nematodes can play an important role in the nitrogen cycle by way of nitrogen mineralization. The common plant parasitic nematode genera are fairly easy to identify to that level using a standard compound microscope. Identification of nematodes to the species level often requires detailed morphological analysis, growth of the nematode on a different host plants, or DNA or isozyme analysis. Common morphological features used in nematode identification include the mouth cavity, that is, and the shape of the stylet, the shape and overlap of the pharyngeal glands with the intestine, size and shape of the nematode body at an adult stage, size of the head, tail, and a number of position of ovaries in the female. Most subtle characters may include number of lines on the nematode's cuticle or the presence or absence of pore-like sensory organs. Plant parasitic nematodes occur in all sizes and shapes. The typical nematode shape is a long and slender worm-like animal, but often the adult animals are swollen and no longer even resemble worms. Plant parasitic nematodes range from 250 micrometers to 12 millimeters in length, averaging 1 millimeter, to about 15 to 35 micrometers in width. While nematodes may look dramatically different, they share some common features. Nematodes often look segmented because of the numerous annulations, which is accordion-like transverse grooves on the cuticle that allow the nematode to bend without kinking. But in fact, nematodes are unsegmented and have no replication of body parts throughout the worm. Like most higher animals, nematodes possesses bilateral symmetry, but with a superimposed trilateral and hexalateral symmetry. Developmentally, nematodes are triploblastic, containing three body layers, that is the ectoderm, the mesoderm, and the endoderm in the embryo. Most higher organisms are triploblastic and have a coelom, a body cavity surrounded by a mesoderm. Nematodes have body cavity that is not totally surrounded by mesoderm, so they are pseudocoelomic. Nematodes do not have a skeleton, but they do have hypodermis, which functions as a flexible support for their muscles. Nematode muscles are arranged along the longitudinal axis of the worm, thus allowing the body of the nematode to move only in a sinusoidal or a snake-like motion. Nematodes have no defined respiratory or circulatory systems. They depend on diffusion of water, gases, and metabolites in and out of their semi-permeable body walls and internal transport by mixing of the pseudocoelomic fluid as the nematode moves. This lack of respiratory and circulatory system prevents nematodes from becoming larger in cross-sectional area, but does not limit their length. The largest nematode found thus far was more than 7 meters long and 1 centimeter in diameter. Nematodes have a sophisticated nervous system and sensory organs to help them find their host plant, to locate specific plant cell types, and to mate and to reproduce. Thank you.